Hey everybody, CPO from Maybe I'm Amazed, back with my friend Laurence Juber from Wings. Today we are going through another track from the Back to the Egg record album. Records or songs. I always forget that.
Oh no, records are records.
Records are records.
From yeah. Back to the Egg LP.
There you go. Back to the Egg LP yeah. by Wings. Wings. Not Wings. Paul McCartney and Wings. Wings. That's right. So this is Rockestra Theme. Let's check it out.
Rock orchestra.
Wow. So what's going on there? There's a couple of bands, right?
Abbey Road Studio 2.
Yeah.
October 3rd, 1978. It was, the guitar section was Pete Townsend, Dave Gilmore, Denny Lane, Hank Marvin from The Shadows.
Okay.
Great, one of the great English guitar players, and myself. Drums were John Bonham, Kenny Jones, and Steve Holly. Morris Pert was studio percussionist playing timps. Ray Cooper, I think, was on tambourine. Bass playing on that, Paul played piano. John Paul Jones, Ronnie Lane, and Bruce Thomas from the Elvis Costello's Attractions. So three bass players. Three bass players, three drummers. Paul on piano, Linda on B3 organ, Gary Brooker, I think, was on the session. I forget. I mean, we had the horn section. We had other percussion players.
Yeah.
And it was...
I'm sure somebody out there knows.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I have pictures.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Yeah.
But it was, you know, Paul had this idea of a rock orchestra. And we recorded two tunes, this one and then So Glad to See You Here, which comes up later in the album, in one afternoon session. First time I'd seen two 24-track machines synced up together.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. They had to bring in an extra console into the control room because there weren't enough inputs for everybody. I mean, it was really a tour de force from an engineering point of view.
I bet.
Phil McDonald was the engineer for the album.
Just one engineer?
Well, I mean, he had assistants.
Okay, okay.
It's never just one engine.
Right. So did you guys do this? This is completely live? Or?
Yeah, that's in the room.
Wow.
Except, I think that we overdubbed the Why Haven't I Had Any Dinner?
Mm.
And that was Paul's idea. It's like, you know, the old big bands get up, you know, Pennsylvania 6-5000 kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Just kind of something to break up the instrumental thing. But that was the first ever Grammy awarded for rock instrumental.
In the history of the Grammys?
Yeah,
or?
That was the first time they ever had a rock instrumental category.
Interesting. Wasn't there was
I don't
somebody
think
else?
They had that anymore.
Weren't you guys up against somebody else that was?
I forget.
Yeah, I thought I read about that. Who was it, guys? Let us know in the comments.
I'm sure we can Google it.
Yeah, of course. But you know, that's what you have the audience for.
That's true.
They love looking these things up. Yeah. Actually, most of them already know what it is. So
yeah.
Anyways, so. Not only are we here listening to Back to the Egg, but we're talking about Laurence's new record that's coming out February the 9th. That's right. It's called A Day in My Life. It's all instrumental versions of Beatles songs.
Beatle tunes.
That's right. Beatle tunes.
It's kind of, you know, I've done over the years, I've done 4 albums in the LJ Plays the Beatles
songs. Yeah.
And this is kind of a best of, but not exactly, because there's things I left off.
Yeah.
And things I put in there that just fit kind of the overall concept, and it was conceived for vinyl. I wanted to do a vinyl release on this, so 12 tracks. You go over 20 minutes per side, and you start losing volume.
Yeah,
on vinyl, so it's nowhere near as forgiving as
is
the
that.
Is.
So I heard you do Maybe I'm Amazed the other night. Is that
no? That's on my One Wing album.
Okay, got it.
When I gave Paul LJ Plays the Beatles, he said, "Well, what about Wings?" So, after a few years, I decided, Hope, you know, my wife Hope, who was the one who came up with the idea of doing these Beatle albums, and she produces them, she said, you know, Paul wants you to do Wings. So I succumbed, as I usually do. She gets her way.
So this is kind of a debate, right? Is Maybe I'm Amazed, is it a Beatles song?
No, it's
a Wings song?
It's a Paul song. I mean, Wings did
it. Yeah. Didn't they start? He started writing that during the.
He wrote it. Yeah. I mean, you know, but it's, you know, it's on the McCartney album. There's a version on the Wings Over America one. Then we did a different, slightly different arrangement of it.
Yeah. I think there's a little bit in the Let It Be, like the filming. Yeah. You know.
Well, there was all kinds of stuff floating around that didn't manifest itself until post Beatles.
Right.
You know, same with George.
Right.
But, you know, it's what you can see from that is how Paul, as a musical director, has very specific ideas. You know, it's like he and George got into that tiff about Paul wanting George to play straight fours on Get Back. And, you know, it's on the record. Whether I don't know if George played it or Paul played it, but it's part of the groove.
Yeah,
and, you know, he knows what he wants to hear.
Yeah,
and you know, I mean, when I was in Wings, I had plenty of opportunities to express my own take on things. But you know, when he had something specific, I'd play something specific. But I was given a lot of freedom.
Nice.
In the solos. Yeah,
that's one thing about the Get Back documentary that was cool for me is like, because Let It Be is such a narrative.
Yeah.
It's almost like they wanted you to think a certain way.
Whereas, right. Well, that was the idea, the way it was edited. What's interesting is you can't see it on camera, but I have the poster, the original poster, Let It Be, you know, is not fully capitalized. It's in quotes,
mm-hmm.
and it's just the only capital is the L.
Oh, yeah.
Let.
Yeah.
It's like, it's just a statement.
Yeah.
It's not even a title.
Hmm. Interesting.
Never thought about it like
that,
didn't you?
No.
Yeah.
Never noticed
that. I looked at it one day, I thought, wait a minute. You know, if it was a title, it would be fully capitalized.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting. Huh. Yeah. So that's, I mean, like in the newest documentary, it's that whole thing with him and George doesn't seem so, like there's so much animosity.
Well, except George quit.
Right. Yeah, there is that.
Yeah.
And then also, like, the whole dictatorship vibe that's in Let It Be.
Well, because the thing is that it's only a dictatorship if you don't have a perspective on what it takes in order to whip a band into shape.
Yeah.
And, you know, seeing Paul in action the way... And that's how he works.
Yeah.
I mean, he knows what he wants to hear and you know, he gets what he wants.
Yeah. Anyways, we will get on to the next song for tomorrow. That's To You. To You.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that tomorrow. And make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell so you'll know when the next video is coming out. And just like always, everybody, peace and love.